This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Rhoticity in English refers to the situations in which English speakers pronounce the historical rhotic consonant, r, and is one of the most prominent distinctions by which varieties of English can be classified. The English dialects of Scotland, Ireland, and most of the United States and Canada preserve historical, r, and are thus termed the rhotic varieties. The non-rhotic varieties, in which historical, r, has been lost except before vowels, include all the dialects of England, except the southwest, the southern West Midlands, and parts of West Lancashire, as well as the English dialects of Australia, New Zealand, South Africa, and some parts of the southern and eastern coastal United States. In non-rhotic varieties, speakers no longer pronounce r in postvocalic environments, that is, when it is immediately after a vowel and not followed by another vowel. For example, a rhotic English speaker pronounces the words ˈhɑːrd and ˈbʌtər as h rhode and ˈbʌtər, whereas a non-rhotic speaker drops or deletes the r sound, pronouncing them as hd and bt. A non-rhotic speaker usually still pronounces the r in the continuously spoken phrase butter and jam the linking r, since in this case the r is followed by a vowel. Loss of postvocalic r began sporadically in informal speech in the 15th century, and by the 17th century postvocalic r was weakened but still universally present. In the mid-18th century it was still pronounced in most environments, but may occasionally have been deleted entirely, especially after low vowels. By the 1790s, postvocalic r less pronunciation had become common in London and surrounding areas, and was being increasingly used even in more formal and educated speech. By the early 19th century, the Southern British Standard was fully transformed into a non-rhotic variety, though some variation persisted as late as the 1870s. This change influenced American port cities with close connections to Britain, causing upper-class pronunciation in many eastern and southern port cities such as New York City, Boston, Philadelphia, Alexandria, Charleston, and Savannah to become non-rhotic. Non-rhotic pronunciation continued to influence American prestige speech until the 1860s, when the American Civil War shifted America's centers of wealth and political power to areas with fewer cultural connections to the old colonial and British elites. This largely removed the prestige associated with non-rhotic pronunciation in America, such that when the advent of radio and television in the early 20th century established a national standard of American pronunciation, it became a rhotic variety that fully preserves historical r contents. 1 history, 2 modern pronunciation, 3 distribution. 31 England, 32 United States, 33 Canada, 34 New Zealand, 35 Asia, 36 Africa. 4 mergers. Characteristic of non-rhotic accents. 5 effect on spelling. 6 references. 61 footnotes. 62 works cited. History. Red areas indicate where rural accents were rhotic in the 1950s, based on H. Orton et al. Survey of English dialects, 1962-71. Some areas with partial rhoticity, for example parts of the East Riding of Yorkshire, are not shaded on this map. Red areas are where English dialects of the late 20th century were rhotic, based on P. Trudgill. The dialects of England. The earliest traces of a loss of r in English appear in the early 15th century and occur before coronal consonants, especially s, giving modern s buttocks. Old English ears, Middle English ers or ars, and base fish. OE bears, ME bars. A second phase of R loss began during the 15th century, and was characterized by sporadic and lexically variable deletion, such as moning morning and cadenal cardinal. These R less spellings appear throughout the 16th and 17th centuries, but are uncommon and are restricted to private documents, especially ones written by women. No English authorities describe loss of R in the standard language prior to the mid-18th century, and many do not fully accept it until the 1790s. During the mid-17th century, a number of sources describe r as being weakened but still present. The English playwright Ben Jonson's English Grammar, published posthumously in 1640, records that r was sounded firme in the beginning of words, and more liquid in the middle and ends. Little more is said regarding r until 1740, when one Mather Flint, writing in a primer for French learners of English, said, dans plusieurs mots, leur devant une consonne est fort adoucie, presque muet. indicate the long vowel of ant in his 1775 rhyming dictionary in his influential Critical Pronouncing Dictionary and Expositor of the English Language 1791, Walker reported, with a strong tone of disapproval, that the r in lard, bard, is pronounced so much in the throat as to be little more than the middle or Italian a, lengthened into ba, baad. Americans returning to England after the end of the American Revolutionary War in 1783 reported surprise at the significant changes in fashionable pronunciation by the early 19th century. The Southern British Standard was fully transformed into a non-rhotic variety, though it continued to be variable as late as the 1870s. The adoption of postvocalic, r, less pronunciation as the British prestige standard in the late 18th and early 19th centuries influenced American port cities with close connections to Britain, causing upper-class pronunciation in many eastern and southern port cities such as New York City, Boston, Philadelphia, Alexandria, Charleston, and Savannah to become non-rhotic like regional dialects in England. The accents of other areas in America remained rhotic in a display of linguistic lag that preserved the original pronunciation of r. Non-rhotic pronunciation continued to influence American prestige speech until the 1860s, when the American Civil War shifted America's centers of wealth and political power to areas with fewer cultural connections to the British elite. By 1870, New York City had become America's national center of commerce and entrepreneurship, and its political and economic leaders were increasingly self-made men with little connection to the old colonial elites and British non-rhotic pronunciation. This largely removed the prestige associated with non-rhotic pronunciation in America, such that when the advent of radio and television in the early 20th century established a national standard of American pronunciation, it became a rhotic variety that fully preserves historical, r, modern pronunciation in most non-rhotic accents. If a word ending in written r is followed closely by a word beginning with a vowel, the r is pronounced, as in water ice. This phenomenon is referred to as linking r. Many non-rhotic speakers also insert an epenthetic r between vowels when the first vowel is one that can occur before syllable final r. Drawing for drawing, this so-called intrusive r has been stigmatized, but nowadays many speakers of received pronunciation frequently intrude an epenthetic r at word boundaries, especially where one or both vowels is schwa. For example, the idea of it becomes the idea R of it, Australia and New Zealand becomes Australia R and New Zealand, the formerly well-known India R office and Laura Norder, Law and Order. The typical alternative used by RP speakers is to insert a glottal stop where an intrusive R would otherwise be placed. For non-rhotic speakers, what was historically a vowel plus R is now usually realized as a long vowel. This is called compensatory lengthening, lengthening that occurs after the elision of a sound. So in received pronunciation, RP and many other non-rhotic accents, card, fern, born are pronounced, or similar actual pronunciations vary from accent to accent. This length may be retained in phrases, so while car pronounced in isolation is car owner is, but a final schwa usually remains short, so water in isolation is in RP and similar accents. The vowels, I, and, U, or, when followed by r, become diphthongs ending in schwa, so near is and poor is, though these have other realizations as well, including monophthongal ones. Once again, the pronunciations vary from accent to accent. The same happens to diphthongs followed by r, though these may be considered to end in r in rhotic speech, and it is the r that reduces to schwa as usual in non-rhotic speech. Tire said in isolation as in sour is. For some speakers, some long vowels alternate with a diphthong ending in schwa, so where may be, but wearing. Even general American speakers commonly drop the r in non-final unstressed syllables when another syllable in the same word also contains r. This may be referred to as r dissimilation. Examples include the dropping of the first r in the word surprise, governor, and caterpillar in more careful speech. However, the r sounds are all retained distribution. Final post-vocalic, r, in farmer in English rural dialects of the 1950s. Green, non-rhotic yellow, alveolar orange, retroflex pink, retroflex Antigua and Barbuda, and the Bahamas. They also include current-day New York City English, New York Latino English, and some Boston English. Non-rhotic accents in the Americas include the rest of Caribbean and Belize. England, though most English varieties in England are non-rhotic, rhotic accents are found in the West Country south and west of a line from near Shrewsbury to around Portsmouth, the Corby area, some of Lancashire north and west of the centre of Manchester, some parts of Yorkshire and Lincolnshire, and in the areas that border Scotland. The prestige form, however, however, exerts a steady pressure towards non-rhoticity, thus the urban speech of Bristol or Southampton is more accurately described as variably rhotic, the degree of rhoticity being reduced as one moves up the class and formality scales. The red dots show major U.S. cities where Lebov, Ash, and Boburg 2006-48 found 50% or higher non-rhotic speech among at least one white resident African American vernacular Englishes. Non-rhotic speech may be found among working and middle-class African Americans throughout the country. United States American English is predominantly rhotic today, but at the end of the 19th century non-rhotic accents were common throughout much of the eastern U.S. and through much of the South. Along the Gulf Coast, this trend reversed during the mid-20th century, in large part due to the influence of more Western-influenced television, as well as the increasing political influence of states to the west, the Upper Midwest, and then California and Texas. Non-rhotic pronunciations have increasingly been perceived by Americans as sounding foreign, with rhotic accents increasingly seen as sounding American today. Non-rhoticity in the American South is found primarily among older speakers, and only in some areas such as central and southern Alabama, Savannah, Georgia, and Norfolk, Virginia, as well as in the yacht accent of New Orleans. The local dialects of eastern New England, especially Boston, Massachusetts, extending into the states of Maine and New Hampshire, are largely non-rhotic, as well as the traditional Rhode Island dialect. However, this feature has recently been receding. The New York City dialect is traditionally non-rhotic, though William Lebov more precisely classifies its current form as variably rhotic, with many of its sub-varieties now fully rhotic, such as in northeastern New Jersey. African American vernacular English is largely non-rhotic, and in some non-rhotic Southern and AAVE accents, there is no linking R, that is, R, at the end of a word is deleted even when the following word starts with a vowel, so that Mr. Adams is pronounced in a few such accents. Intervocalic, R, is deleted before an unstressed syllable even within a word when the following syllable begins with a vowel in such accents. Pronunciations like for Carolina, or for bear up, are heard. This pronunciation also occurs in AAVE typically. Even non-rhotic modern American English varieties do pronounce the R in R, as in bird, work, or perky, realizing it, as in most of the U.S., as or. Languages, whilst some tend to be non-rhotic in the case of the Philippines, this may be explained because the English that is spoken there is heavily influenced by the American dialect. In addition, many East Asians in China, Japan, Korea, and Taiwan who have a good command of English generally have rhotic accents because of the influence of American English. This excludes Hong Kong, whose RP English dialect as a result of its almost 150-year history as a British Crown colony, later British dependent territory. However, many older and younger speakers among South and East Asians speak non-rhotic. Other Asian regions with non-rhotic English are Malaysia, Singapore, and Brunei. Citation needed. A typical Malaysian English would be almost totally non-rhotic due to the non-existence of rhotic endings in both languages of influence, whereas a more educated Malaysian's English may be non-rhotic due to standard Malaysian English being based on RP received pronunciation. A typical teenager's Southeast Asian English would be rhotic, mainly because of prominent influence by American English. Spoken English in Myanmar is non-rhotic, but there are a number of English speakers with a rhotic or partially rhotic pronunciation. Sri Lankan English may be rhotic. Africa. The English spoken in Africa excluding South Africa is based on British RP and is officially non-rhotic. Pronunciation and variation in African English accents are largely affected by native African language influences, level of education, and exposure to Western influences. The English accents spoken in the coastal areas of West Africa is primarily non-rhotic, as are the underlying varieties of Niger-Congo languages spoken in that part of West Africa. Rhoticity may be present in English spoken in areas where rhotic Afro-Asiatic or Nilo-Saharan languages are spoken across northern West Africa and in the Nilotic regions of East Africa. More modern trends show an increasing African American influence on African English pronunciation, particularly among younger urban affluent populations, where the American rhotic R may be overstressed in informal communication to create a pseudo-Americanized accent. By and large, official spoken English used in post-colonial African countries is non-rhotic. Mergers. Characteristic of non-rhotic accents. Some phonemic mergers are characteristic of non-rhotic accents. These usually include one item that historically contained an R lost in the non-rhotic accent, and one that never did so. The section below lists mergers in order of approximately decreasing prevalence. Panda-pander merger. In the terminology of John C. Wells, this consists of the merger of the lexical sets comma and letter. It is found in all or nearly all non-rhotic accents, and is even present in some accents that are in other respects rhotic, such as Those of some speakers in Jamaica and the Bahamas homophonous pairs. Carter KT Cheetah Cheater TT Darla Dollar DL with God Guard Merger Dina Diner Dan Coca Coker Cock Coda Coder Code. Cola Kohler Cole Coma Comer Com Custody Custody Case D Data Dater Dead Easton Eastern I Satan Helena Eleanor Lane. With H dropping outside North America Ada Eater IT Ein Iron and Feta Fetter Foot formerly F Malie Geta Getter T Ion Iron. Ann Karma Kamer K M Kava Carver K V Lena Leaner Lee and Lima Lemur Lee M Lisa Leeser Lee S Luna Lunar. LJUN Maya Meyer Ma Maya Meyer Ma Maya Meyer Ma Maya Meyer Ma Mana Manor Main Mana Manor. Main Marta Martyr M T Mia Mir Mi Minor Mina, Mina Man Minor Mina, Mina Man Mona Moner Mon Palma Palmer, Palmer. PM Panda Pander Pan Parka Parker PK Parma Palmer, Palmer PM Patton Pattern Payton Peta Peter, Peter Pi T Pharma Farmer. FM Peta Peter, Peter Pi T Rota Rotor Ro with intervocalic alveolar flapping Rita Reader Re with intervocalic alveolar flapping Roma Romer Rom Rota Rotor Rot. Saba Saber, Saber Seb Schema Schemer Ski M7 Severn Sivan Soya Sawyer S Tiger Tiger Ta Terra, Terra Terra Ter. Tuba Tuber TJU B Tuna Tuner TJU and Vespa Vesper VSB Via Veer V Wanda Wander Wind Weston Western Westian. Wicca Wicker Weak Father Farther Merger in Wells terminology, this consists of the merger of the lexical sets palm and start it is found in the speech of the great majority of non-rhotic speakers, including those of England, Wales, the United States, the Caribbean, Australia, New Zealand and South Africa. It may be absent in some non-rhotic speakers in the Bahamas homophonous pairs. With smoothing arms arms mz arms harms mz with h dropping bami barmi bmi commer karma k m chalmers charmers tms. Dahmer dharma dmfa far f father farther f ed kava carver k v lava larva l v mam r m. Pa par p palma parma p m palmer, palmer parma p m ska scar sk spa spar sp pon porn merger in Wells terminology, this consists of the merger of the lexical sets thought and north it is found in most of the same accents as the father farther merger. Described above, but is absent from the Bahamas and Guyana homophonous pairs. Ok ork k bok bork bk bon born bn cock cork kk cod cord kd. Draw drawer Dr. Na nor N hawk ork K with H dropping Lod Lord LD Lon Lorn. LN Pon Porn PN Sot Sort ST Stock Stork Street K Tok Tork TK Tot Tort TT Tot Tort. TT Tot Tor T Thaw Thor Theta Cot Court Merger in Wells terminology, this consists of the merger of the lexical sets thought and force it is found in those non-rhotic accents containing the Pon Porn merger that have also undergone the Horse-Horse merger. These include the accents of Southern England, Wales, non-rhotic New York City speakers, Trinidad and the Southern Hemisphere. In such accents a three-way merger ah or results homophonous pairs. Ah or bod board bd bod board bd. Bon born bn bon born, born, born bn cot court kt ka cor k da door d draw drawer doctor. Flaw floor Florida fought fort ft god gord d ha hor h la lor l ma mor m. Ma mor m pa por p ra roar r sa source ss sa sor s. Sa sor s sod sort sd sod sort sd shan shorn n sha shor shan shorn n. Ta tor ti ya yor j calv carve merger in Wells terminology, this consists of the merger of the lexical sets bath and start it is found in some non-rhotic accents with brada in words like bath. It is general in Southern England excluding rhotic speakers, Trinidad, the Bahamas, and the Southern Hemisphere. It is a possibility for Welsh, Eastern New England, Jamaican, and Guyanese speakers homophonous pairs.